Dear friends, welcome to Civil Conclave presentation. In quantitative survey part 2, we are going to discuss about shuttering calculations and brickwork calculation. See, these are some of the images of how the formwork carried out in various sites. Shuttering and shuttering area calculation. See, for a size of 5 feet by 4 feet by 3 feet, how to do a shuttering area calculation. This is what we are going to discuss about in this slide. Okay. Shuttering and shuttering area will be side area. That is, this is known as a side area. Side area, that is length and breadth. Okay. Multiplied by 2 will give you the shuttering area calculation. Okay. That means 5 feet by 4 feet. Whole multiplied by 2 feet into 3 plus 5 into 4, that is 740 square feet of area. That is inclusive of the bottom area. So, you know, for a net columns, how to calculate the net columns area, we are going to discuss about. Net column area is 1 feet by 1 feet. Size of the footing is 5 feet by 4 feet by 3 feet. Here I'm talking about net column means starting from the bottom. Okay. This will be shuttering and area is equal to slide area. That is peripheral length into depth. That is length into breadth. Okay. Whole divided by, whole multiplied by 2 into depth. That means 1 plus 1 into 2 into 5. That is 20 square feet of area is a net column shuttering area. Now let us talk about a plinth beam area, how to do a shuttering. Okay, plinth beam is 12 feet by 9 inches, that is a 75 into 1 feet. Area will be counted for a entire wooden shuttering area. Okay, see, this is a plinth beam. What I given a depth here, breadth here, I show it to you. Length into depth into 2 plus length into B. Okay. That is length into D into 2 means that is the two sides. Length into breadth, that means the bottom side. That is 12 feet into 1 feet into 2 feet plus 12 feet into 9 inches. That is a 0.75. That is 33 feet square feet. Okay. For a column, of the column size of 1 feet by 1 feet by 10 feet height. Okay. This, how we are going to do the calculation? Surface area, that is length, breadth, okay, multiplied by 2, that will be give you the total peripheral area and into depth. That means 1 plus 1 into 2 into 10, that will be 40 square feet of area for this particular column. Then how to do a beam shuttering area? Okay, floor beam is 12 feet by 9 inches, that is 75 into 1 feet. Okay, this is this. This means length and depth multiplied by 2 plus length into breadth. That is length into depth into 2 means both the sides. And length into breadth means bottom area. That means 12 into 1 into 2 plus 12 into 0.75. That is 33 square foot of area. See, this is the sides and this is the bottom. Okay. This known as a sides and this known as a bottom. And slab area, how to calculate the slab area? Slab area, the size has been given 10 feet by 12 feet and the 6 inches is the height. How to calculate the shuttering area? Side area plus bottom area is equal to peripheral length into depth plus bottom area. That means length 12 feet, depth 10 feet multiplied by 2, then into depth, that is a side shuttering, that is 6 inches, okay, that is a 0.5, then plus length into breadth, 10 feet by 12 feet. This gives you 142 square feet of area. Here you can see that in this image, I show you, this is the sides, okay, this is the bottom, okay, and this area is a slab shuttering top area. Now, if a slab size is 17 feet by 53 feet, and a 5 feet is the height. There are staircases, two staircases. One is 7 feet by 17 feet. Duct will be 1 feet. Duct number one will be, that is a duct number one. Duct number two, okay. Duct number one will be 11 feet by 6 inches. Duct number two will be 2 feet 6 inches by 8 inches. How to calculate the shuttering area? Shuttering area, slide area, that is the side area, plus bottom area, that is the bottom area, total area, is equal to peripheral length into depth plus bottom area. That means 147 into 0.5, that is 6 inches, plus 744.50, that is 818 square feet. Peripheral length of the slip. You mean to say that 17 feet, then 53 feet, okay? Then there's a 17 feet, okay? Then 1 feet multiplied by 2 plus 53, that is a 2 plus 53, that means two sides, okay? Plus 2.5 into 2, that is 147 square feet of area. Thickness of the slab is 6 inches, that is a 5 inches. So bottom area of the slab will be 17 into 53 plus 1 into 10. That is a projected slab area. Okay, this is a projected slab area here I'm giving you. This is a 1 feet, this width is 10 feet. That will be 911 square feet. Detection. For duct number one, okay, it will be having 11 feet by 2.5 inches, that is 27.5 feet square feet. Duct will be 2.5 by 8, okay, this is a 2.5 by 8, okay, that is 20 square feet of area. Staircases, the staircase will be 7 feet by 17 feet, that is, this is a staircase, 7 feet by 17 feet, is equal to 119 square feet area. So total bottom area of the slab after the deductions will be 744.5 square feet of area. Now, how to calculate this rectangular, irregular shape shuttering? You have to divide it into 5 sections. Okay. First one will be a rectangle, second one will be a triangle, rectangle, triangle, rectangle, and a circular area. The width of the building is 40 feet. Length will be 64 feet, okay? This will be, first I consider as a 12 feet, a rectangular portion, okay? Then I'll consider a triangle portion of 8 feet. Then I consider a rectangle portion of 18 feet. That is mean the length will be of this also. Then triangle portion of 9 feet. Then rectangular portion of 19 feet. Then semicircle area is, which is known as A6 will be 12 feet, okay? Shuttering and shuttering area, side area plus bottom area is equal to peripheral length into depth plus bottom area. That means 182.152 into 0.5. Okay, that is plus 1843.194. That is 1934.27 square feet. Peripheral length of the slab will be 40 plus 49. Okay, plus 2 into pi into 12 into pi and 5, that is 6 inches, plus 10 plus 13.453 plus 10 plus 10 plus 12. That is 182.152. Thickness of the slab is 6 inches, that I called as a 5. Now I'm going to explain you how I divided these breakups and the calculation in this slide. Using Pythagoras theorem, you can find out the inclined length. Inclined length means this is a inclined length, what I'm talking about it, okay? V is equal to a square plus b square. C is equal to v into 10 square plus 19 square, 9 square whole is equal to 13.453 feet. V is equal to c 6 square plus 8 square, that is 10 feet. Bottom area can be found out the by this method, what I showing you in the picture. A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6. Like this, you can take it out. A1, that is length into breadth is equal to 40 into 12, 480 square feet. A2, area of the triangle is equal to 0.5 into length into breadth. That means 0.5 into 8 feet into 6 feet, 240 square feet. Area 3, again, is a rectangle. Length and breadth, 34 by 18 feet, 612 square feet. Area 4, A4 is equal to area of triangle is equal to 0.5 into length into B, breadth, that is 0.5 into 9 into 10, that is 45 square feet of area. Area 5, again a rectangle, length and breadth, 24 into 19, 456 square foot of area. Area is equal to semicircle area, that is pi divided by 4 into d square, that is a formula, into 0.5, that is the thickness. That means pi by 4 into 24 square into 0.5 is equal to 226.194 square feet. So hence the total area of the slab will be A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, all total put together, 1843.194 square feet of area. Now, how to calculate the shuttering for a four column, four beam? If the column sizes has been 12 inches by 9 inches, that means 1 feet by 0.75. Height of the ceiling is 10 feet. Slab thickness is 6 inches. That means 6 inches means 0.5. That's what the side direction. Okay. Size of the beam along vertical axis is 12 feet by 9 feet by 1 feet. Here I show you what is the height of the beam, the length of the beam, width of the beam, ceiling height, floor column. Ceiling height will be 10 feet 6 inches, that is including the slab thickness. Now how to calculate size? Length is equal to 13 feet 6 inches minus 9 inches by 9 inches, that is a 12 feet. How do you derive the 13 feet 9 inches 9 inches? 13.5, this is a 9 inches, this my thickness and this thickness. Okay, this is what the, what you call as, you know, beam width will be from here to here. So 13.5, this 9 inches, this 9 inches, we deducted it. Hence, we bought a figure of 12 feet. Okay. Breadth will be 14 feet minus 1 feet by minus 1 feet, 12 feet. Depth is 6 inches, that is a 5.5 feet. Floor column. Shuttering of the area of the floor column is equal to length into breadth, whole multiplied by 2 into depth into numbers. That means 1 plus 0.75 multiplied by 12 into 10 into 4. That is 140 square feet of area. Okay. We have considered, even though the ceiling height I given a 10.5, we consider the column height only as a 10, that 0.5 is the slab thickness area. Floor beam along horizontal axis. Shuttering and slab shuttering area will be side area of the beam plus bottom area of the beam, whole multiplied by number of beams. That is length is equal to 13 feet 6 inches, that is a 0.5 minus 9.9. How I deducted a minus 9.9, I already shown to you, is equal to length into depth into 2 plus length into B into number of beams. That is length is equal to 12 feet. Hence 12 into 1 into 2 plus 12 into 0.75, that is 9 inches, whole multiplied by 2 will be 66 square feet of area. Floor beam on the vertical area. Okay. Length is equal to 14 minus 1 into minus 1. Like that, how I deducted 9 inches, the same methodology. This will be length plus depth into 2 plus length into breadth, whole multiplied by number of beams. That is, length is equal to 12 feet. Hence, it will be 12 feet into 1 feet into 2 feet plus 12 into 9 inches, that is a 0.75, multiplied by 2 will be 66 square feet of area. Floor slab. Shuttering and shuttering area is equal to side area of the slab plus bottom area of the slab, which means peripheral length into depth into bottom of the slab. That means length into breadth multiplied by 2 into depth plus length into breadth. That is equal to 13.5 plus 14 whole multiplied by 2 into 5, that is 6 inches, plus 13.5 into 4, that is 216.5 square foot of area. Okay. Now again, the floor beam, floor slab area. Okay. The same methodology which I shown you here, S1, S2, will have 11 feet by 14 feet. This will be 11.6 feet by 14 feet. The total length will be 24.9 feet and height will be 10.5. slab thickness will be 6 inches. This is the floor columns. Ceiling would be at 10.6. Okay. Now let us go to the column. Floor column. Peripheral length into depth into number of columns. Length into breadth. Whole multiplied by 2 into D into numbers. That is 1 into 0.75. That is the 9 inches. Whole multiplied by 2 into 10 into 6. That is 210 square foot of area. Okay. Now floor beam horizontal axis. Shuttering area, side area of the beam plus bottom area of the beam, whole multiplied by number of beams. That means L is equal to 11 into 11.5 is equal to length into depth into 2 plus length into breadth into number of beams. Length is 22.5. Hence, it is the calculation will be 22.5 into 1 into 2 plus 22.5 into 0.75. That is the 9 inches. Whole multiplied by 2 will give you 123.75 square foot of area. Now, floor beam along the vertical axis. The formula will be remain same. So, length will be 12 feet. That means 12 into 1 into 2 plus 12 into 75, that is 9 inches, into 3, that is 99 square feet. Floor slab area. That means side area of the slab plus bottom area of the slab. That means peripheral length into depth into bottom area of the slab. Length plus breadth multiplied by 2 multiplied by depth plus length into breadth. That means 24.75 plus 14 whole multiplied by 2 into 5. That is a 6 inches thickness plus 24.75 into 14. That is 382.5 square foot of area. Now let us come to how to calculate the shuttering area. See here, the landing will be 4 feet. The staircase rises and treaders width will be 10 feet. The landing one will be 4 feet. The staircase width will be 7 feet. Okay, here I show you the landing height will be 6 inches. The total height will be 10.6 inches. And only the height of the floor will be 10 feet. Treads will be 12. Riser will be 6. Here, the mid-landing I show you. The mid-landing height will be 5 feet. Here, I show you 10 feet, 4 feet, 4 feet. I show you. This height will be 11.18. Now, how to calculate? Let us go. Base slab, S1 and S2. Okay. That will be side area of the slab plus bottom area of the slab. Into number of slabs by Pythagoras theory. Using the Pythagoras theory, a square plus b square is equal to c square. That means length into depth into 2 plus length into breadth is equal to number of slab. C is equal to v divided by a square b square. That means 11.18 into 0.5 into 2 plus 11.18 plus 3.5 into 2. C is equal to V is equal to 10 square plus 5 square. That is 100.62 square feet. C is equal to 11.18. That is, this 11.18 is the inclined length. Okay. Now, centering and stripe area. Okay. Side area of the steps plus front area of the steps multiplied by the number of steps. 0.5, that is 6 inches, into breadth, into height, into 2 plus length and depth, whole multiplied by number of steps. That means 0.5 into 1, that is the breadth. Height will be 9 inches. The 6 inches, that is 0.5, multiplied by 2. Width is 3.5. Okay, that is a 3.5. That is 3 feet 6 inches. Height will be 6 inches. And the number of steps will be 20. So that will be 45 square feet of area. Landing L1, L2, okay, that is a straightaway rectangle area, breadth plus depth into 2, plus length plus depth, plus length plus breadth, into number of a landing. That is 4 feet by 6 inches, multiplied by 2, plus, this is a one landing, second landing will be 7 feet, multiplied by 6 inches, plus 7 multiplied by 4, into 2, that is 71 square foot of area. Now let us come down to how to do the brickwork calculation. generally the bricks used in India, that is a wire cut bricks what I'm talking about, is 9 feet by 4 feet by 3 inches. Okay, or unless you can say that 0.4 meter or 0.2 meter by 0.2 meter. Okay, dry material proportion. So now I'm telling you dry proportion in m cube, in kgs, in bags, and in cement. Okay, if it is 1:6, sand will be required 0.2 m cube, cement will be 48 in kgs, cement will be in bags will be 0.96, cement will be in cubic meter will be 0.033 cubic meter. If it is 1:5 ratio, sand will be 0.2, cement will be 57.5660 kgs, 1.152 is the number of a bags, 0.04 is in the cubic meter. If it is 1:4, the sand will be 0.2 cubic meter, cement will be 72 kgs, 1.44 bags, that means 0.05 in cubic meter. If it is 1:3, sand will be 0.2, cement will be 96 kgs, 1.92 in bags, 0.066 is the cubic meter volume. Now let us talk about, okay, for 1 m³ of brickwork quantity, sand and cement. Sand is equal to 1 cubic meter, that is a 0.2 cubic meter. Constant is 1:3. Cement is equal to 1:3 m³, that means 0.2 into multiplied by 1440 divided by the 3, that is the last digit of the ratio, because we consider the 1:3. Okay, so now what will be cement in m³ will be 1440 kgs will be 1 m³. Weight of cement divided by m³, 1440 kgs divided by 48, how many cubic meter? That is the 1440 will be 0.33 cubic meter. Note, generally mortar volume should be deducted. If it is to be deducted, it is to be considered as a 20% of the brickwork. Now let us take about one by one solution. For an area of 1200 square feet area, what is the quantum of the brick and cement is required at the ratio of 1:6? If the brick size is 9 inches by 4 inches, wall thickness is 4 inches, height of ceiling is 10 feet. The answer will be like this. Volume of the brickwork is equal to area of the wall into thickness of the wall, that is a 4 inches. That is how many feet? That is 1200 into 0.333. Because we consider 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. That means 399.6 square feet. Okay. Feet cube, that is a cubic feet, divided by 12, that will be 0.333 feet cubic meter. Volume of each bricks will be 0.0625. So number of bricks is required will be volume of the bricks divided by the volume of the brick. Okay, that means 399.6 divided by 0.0625 is equal to 6393.6 bricks. That is approximately 6394 bricks. Cement mortar required for a brick is 1:6. Volume of the brick is 399.6 cubic feet. That means how many cubic meter? That makes 11.324 cubic meter. Since 1 meter is equal to 3.28 running feet, 399.6 divided by 3.283, that is the area. Sand for 1 m³ is equal to 0.2 m³. That is total requirement is 11.324 m³. 11.32 m³ means what? That means 11.324 into 0.02 will give you 2.264 cubic meter of sand is required. Cement, that means for 1 cube, 0.2 divided multiplied by 1440 divided by last cement ratio, that is 1:6 ratio. That will be 48 kgs. 1 cubic meter is equal to 48 kgs. Okay. since the bag is 50 kgs, 11.324 cubic meter means how many cubic meter? So number of bags is 543.552 divided by 5 is equal to 11.324 into 48. That is a 10.87 bag. Okay. 543.552 kgs are approximately equal to 11 bags. For an area of 2000 square feet, how the same calculation? If the wall thickness, if it is a ratio is being 1:5. The same methodologies, area of the brickwork will be 2000 square feet. That means area of the brick will be 9 feet by 3 inches. That means 122 will be 0.187 square feet is equal to 27 feet 2. Okay. Number of bricks is required, area of the brickwork divided by the area of the brick. 2000 divided by 0.1875, that is 10,666.6. That means 10,667 bricks. Cement required with a ratio of 1:5. Volume of the brickwork is equal to 18.873 m cube. Since 1 m cube is equal to 3.828, that is 666 divided by 3.283. Sand, okay, the same methodology, it will give you 57.6 kg. Okay, cement will be 50 kgs in 18.873 m cube. How many kgs required? Number of bags is equal to 1087.84. divided by 50. That means 18.873 multiplied by 57.6 will give you 21.714 bags. That is equal to 1087.84 kgs. This is approximately equal to 22 bags. Now, how to construct what is the material required, a brick and sand? If you construct a room of 14 feet by 16 feet with a height of 10 feet and an opening of the doors, okay, that is 3 feet 6 inches by 7 inches, okay, and all thickness of the wall is 8 inches. Length of the four walls after deduction of the columns, that means all the four columns you deducted, 14 feet into 2 plus 16 feet into 2, that means 14 into 2, 16 into 2. Is equal to 60 feet. Volume of brickwork is equal to length into breadth into depth. That is 8 inches. 8 inches means 0.666. That means 8 divided by 12 will give you 0.666. That means 60 feet into 0.666 into 10 feet. Since 1 is equal to 12 inches, it will make you 399.6 feet cubic meter. 8 by 12 will give you 0.666. Deduction for opening. Doors, 3 feet 5 inches by multiplied by 0.666 into 7, that is the height, will make you 16.317 cubic meter. Lintel deduction, 3.5 plus 0.3333. 333 means 4 inches, okay? That will give you 0.33 feet cube, okay? Total volume of the brickwork will be 399.6 feet cube cubic meter. Minus, that is equal to 16.317 feet cube, minus 16.317 cubic meter, that is for a door, minus 0.923, that is for a lintel, will give you 382.6 cubic meter. Volume of the each brick will be 0.0625 cubic feet. So number of bricks is required. 382.36 divided by 0.0625 will give you 6,117.76 bricks. That means 6,118 bricks. Cement work ratio is 1:6. Sand 1 m cube is equal to 0.2 m cube. That is a sand and cement mortar. Volume of the brickwork will be 386.2 feet cubic meter, 10.58 cubic meters into what? Sands in terms of weight, weight of sand divided by m cube is equal to 1.75 tons. 1 m cube is equal to 1.75 tons. The 167 cubic meter is equal to how many tons? So 1.75 into 2.167, that is 3.792 tons in the terms of weight. Cement required for a brick. 1 cubic meter is equal to 46 kg. That means 0.2 into 1440 divided by the last digit ratio. That means we are talking about a 6. Okay. So that means 0.2 into 1440 whole multiplied divided by 6 will give you 10.835 into 48. That is a 48 kgs. So 520 kgs. So number of bags is required. 520 divided by 50 will give you 10.4 bags. So let us say 11 bags. Okay. This is the same methodology which has been adopted in the other wall thickness. Okay. If this is a room is 26 feet, room 1 and room 2. Length of the external wall, 26 feet into 2 plus 12 into 2. That is 76.2 square feet. Deduction for a length of the column, 1 into 6 into 6 feet. Deduction of the length of the columns vertically, 1 feet by 4 feet is equal to 4 feet. Total length of the external wall will be 76 feet minus 6 feet minus 4 feet will be 66 feet. Volume of the external wall will be length into breadth into D. As wall thickness is 8 inches, we have the calculation of 66 into 0.66 into 9 inches. That is equal to 0.666 feet. That means 395.604 cubic feet. Height of the ceiling is 10 feet. Okay. Depth of the beam is equal to 1 feet. So total height of the wall is 9 feet. Deduction for our opening. Volume of a doors, that is, we given a 2 doors. So length into breadth into depth into number, that is 3.5 into 0.666 into 7 into 2. That is 32.634 cubic feet. Volume of lintel, length plus depth plus breadth. That is, length is equal to 3 feet 6 inches. That means 4.166 into 0.66 into 0.33. Add 4 inches bearing on both the sides is equal to 0.924 cubic feet. Total volume for a brickwork for an external wall will be 395.604 minus 32.604 minus 0.924 will be make you 362.46 cubic feet. Volume of internal wall, length into breadth into depth. Length of the internal wall is equal to 12 feet minus 1 feet minus 1 feet. That will be 10 feet. That is a clear height because 1 feet is a beam depth. That means 10 into 0.333 into 9 inches. That means 29.97 cubic feet. Total volume of the brickwork will be 362.46 plus 29.97. That means 392.07 cubic meter. 108.3 means how many what will be the cubic feet. Volume of each brick's length, breadth, depth. Since 1 inches or 1 feet is equal to 12 inches, 9 into 4 by 3 will be 108 divided by 123, that is 108 inches, 3 inches, that is 0.0625 cubic feet. Okay. Volume of a bricks will be required 6,273 bricks. Cement required. The same methodology what we been explained in the earlier, the same methodology will be adopted. Cement required for a brick, 1 m cube, that means 0.2 multiplied by 1440 divided by the last digit ratio. What we consider is 6, 1 is 6. So it makes you 48 kgs. 1 m cube is required of 48 kgs. So 11.109 cubic meter required how many kgs? That means 11.109 into 48, 533.233 kgs. Each bag of cement is 50 kg. So the number of bags will be required. 533.232 divided by 50 will make you 10.66 spores, approximately 11 bags. Thank you for watching this presentation. Kindly subscribe, like, and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. In case of any queries, do not hesitate to write to me. The response shall be at the earliest. You can write to me civilconclave@gmail.com or at my Telegram group, Civil Conclave Telegram group. The link is as follows. Thank you for watching this presentation. Kindly subscribe and encourage me. Thank you.